Whether we are writing a novel, a blog, an essay, an email, a report, or anything else, words are the tools we use to get the ideas out of our heads and into someone else. So in this process of passively communicating with other minds, it takes a great deal of cognitive power to correct and edit our own writings. Clearly, a software can help us in mitigating at least a majority of this pain. ProWritingAid is one such software. In this video, we will see a complete demo of this software that is also a popular alternative to the Grammarly software. I have used both these tools. You would have seen my other Grammarly review video here. And towards the end of this video, you will also see why I have let go of my Grammarly premium account to expire due to some very important differences between Grammarly and ProWritingAid. This could even help you on deciding which software to use going forward. So make sure you watch this entire video till the end. If you're in a hurry, simply use the table of contents given in the comment section below with timestamps to quickly jump to those parts in the video. Let's begin. From a high-level perspective, we have two ways to use ProWritingAid. Either we can use it within writing apps as an assisting tool or use its web editor online to directly upload your text. We will see how to edit online using the web editor now. Let's go ahead and create the account first. At the time of signing up, simply provide your best email address. Choose a strong password and select what type of writer you are from this drop-down button and click the sign up for free button. Alternatively, you can also use these social logins. Now, since I have already created an account, I'm going to click on this login button directly. This takes me to the web editor. ProWritingAid has improved a lot in the recent past. Its editor was a simple one like this one with robust features, which were mostly reserved for the premium users, but they now have an updated and new editor, which we can view from here. As soon as we land on the new web editor, we see a lot of icons and a couple of options to choose how we want to start our editing process. Either upload your document in word processor format or plain text format. You could also simply copy and paste your text into the web tool. From the horizontal action bar on the header that you see here on the top, we have the menu, writing style selection, and language options. You could also upload your document to edit from this menu option. Additionally, there is also a Word Explorer, which is an excellent tool to spark some creativity with any words, definition, synonym, examples, and more. This is quite useful for finding the right words and sometimes even breaking through our writer's block. It contains a thesaurus, contextually related words, rhymes, and examples from books and much more. This is available from the menu drop-down. Here's a sample text with some errors. Now we can see that there are plenty of reports available to run on our write-up. Note that hitting on the Alt key also gives us with a set of keyboard shortcuts to access these different reports. Let's now go over what these different reports can offer us. Remember, we can run these reports for free, except for the plagiarism check, which needs credits to be purchased. These reports are free only for the first 500 words at a time. So if you have a 1,000-word write-up, you need to break your checks into two, with 500 words each. This limit is removed if you choose to upgrade your license to premium version, which is just $50 per annum, quite cheaper compared to similar tools like Grammarly, which costs close to approximately $130 per annum. You could even get a lifetime premium version of ProWritingAid for just $175. I recommend grabbing this lower price before ProWritingAid changes its pricing model, because at this price, it offers a great deal of editing assistance for any kind of writers. As soon as you have your text in ProWritingAid, you would first want to check this summary report. So let's now click on that. It takes a few seconds to generate a summary dashboard with scores, action items, and statistics. You could also use this button to open the report in a new tab, so you could keep editing while keeping the stats open separately, or even send it to your email or print it for future reference. Imagine you are under a tight deadline and don't have the time to run through each of the variety of reports individually. You can then run the summary report and check to see what needs your attention and correction before publishing your work. This report gives us with a comprehensive overview of our writing and the suggested key actions that can improve our text. These summaries are especially useful for writers who want to track their writing statistics and focus their time effectively. If you notice, there are plenty of suggestions to make the writing better, so choose the ones that best suit your needs, as not all might be helpful for everyone at all times. Which is to say, in other words, that the team at ProWritingAid has exceeded our expectations. The summary report not only analyzes our vocabulary but also shows us how many unique words we have used, how many unusual words we have used, our writing style, grammar and spelling, the diction, if there are any corporate jargons and much, much more. Next comes the style report. The writing styles check is done quite comprehensively here. It checks on passive voice, adverbs, repeated sentence starts, which are more useful for bloggers and fiction writers, readability improvement suggestions, among several other areas of our writing that could be revised. Then comes the grammar check report. This is like any word processing software's grammar check, but with some extra bells and whistles that are great to have. It also looks at the construction of the sentence to make sure that the structure, punctuation, and tense are correct. And yes, of course, it also comes with the spell check, which goes in here with this report. This is not a catch-all, perhaps, for the time being, but this particular section is ever-improving as the ProWritingAid's editors have created thousands of these checks and the list continues to grow each week. Next comes the overused words report. Words that are overused in your write-up gets highlighted here. As simple as that. ProWritingAid categorizes this into 5 types. Words that are too wishy-washy, the telling words rather than showing words, depending on intensifiers like very, so, really, instead of using stronger words to convey deep meanings, non-specific words and other awkward sentence constructions. You can use ProWritingAid's overused words report to highlight all of those words and sentence constructs that you don't want to overuse in your write-up. Of course, the tool doesn't suggest that you need to cut or replace all of them. Rather, they just require a little extra re-examination to make sure that they are your best options. And next we have the readability scores report. The readability report provides an overall readability score for your document. It also gives you a readability score for each paragraph so that you can easily zero in on those passages that could benefit from some corrections. Next we have the cliches and redundancies report. Writers often use cliches when they are working on their first draft because thinking up original wording takes time and can interrupt creative flow. That's fine, but when you go back to edit, this report will pick out instances of unoriginal phrasing so that you can replace them with fresh ideas. Redundant wording creeps into the text of even the most experienced writers. It adds quantity to your writing but not quality, so every word in your writing should be there for a reason. That's where this report comes in to help us in eliminating the clutter. Next in the line is our sticky sentences report. Any sentence that beats around the bush is a sticky sentence. These sentences often lack clarity and hence hard to follow. Here's an example from the ProWritingAid's blog. As you can see, the first example has a sentence length of 27 words, whereas the redraft has a sentence length of 14 words. And the glue index, as you can see, has decreased from 60.7% to 42.8%. thus making the redrafted sentence a more precise and concise one with the same meaning conveyed. Next, we have the diction report. This report provides a list of possible diction problems, highlights vague and abstract words in our writing and provides suggestions on how we can revise them. Because when it comes to writing, less is more. And this report helps us in avoiding unnecessarily complicated write-up by analyzing our word selection and sentence construction. Next, we have the all repeats and echoes check report. It's difficult for writers to check their own work to identify words or terminologies that repeat in their own sentences. This report highlights repeated words or phrases in the document so we can correct them. The echoes report is also quite similar with identifying and highlighting any words or phrases that we have repeated within a short space of writing. Next in the list is our sentence check report. This shows a visual representation of the sentence's length of your writing. ProWritingAid will create a bar graph of your sentence length so that you can pick out areas where you should add more variety. Writing that uses varying sentence lengths helps in engaging the reader, and this report could make that job easier. It even provides the average sentence length, a sentence variety with the target and actual score. Next, we have the thesaurus report. The thesaurus check report shows possible replacements for nouns, verbs, adjectives, and adverbs. These suggestions, as you can see, are often contextually provided, which can allow us to explore a wider vocabulary. Last in the list before the more option is the acronym check. The acronym report highlights all of the acronyms in our text and creates a list of all the acronyms we have used. It shows where they haven't been defined or have been defined after the first occurrence or have been defined multiple times. So these are the three checks that the acronym report will primarily address. One point to note here. Depending on your screen size, the monitor size, the resolution, the icons on the top gets adjusted between the ribbon that we see here and within the more option. So if I move this window across, you can see that the icons gets clubbed inside this more option. So you may not see everything as you are directly seeing on my screen right now. Some of these icons, the options, the reports could be hidden under the more option. So the next in the list is the dialog tags check. This highlights the dialog tags in the text so that you can find a better way to demonstrate emotion. Common examples are said and asked. Minimal dialog tags are preferred for better readability because they help the reader follow the conversation. Wherever possible, use description and action to point out your speaker and build your scene. Next in the list is the consistency check report. It highlights inconsistencies in the usage of single and double quotation marks, special words, capitalizing certain word or place names, spellings, hyphenations, and punctuation, among others. It makes the work appear professional. These inconsistencies are often missed while editing, and it takes a trained set of eyes to find them, but this report makes it easier for us. Next on the list is the pacing check report. ProWritingAid's pacing check finds those areas in your writing that are paced more slowly so that you can spread them out. Pacing refers to the speed at which a story is told and how quickly the reader is moved through events. Good writing contains faster paced sections such as dialogue and character action, as well as slower paced sections such as introspection, backstory, etc. Differently paced sections should ideally complement each other, allowing the reader to move with the writer through the narrative. Then there's these more reports that we can use, like pronoun check, homonym, transition, house, combo, plagiarism. Please note that the plagiarism check requires us to have enough credits, as I have mentioned in the beginning of this video, which could be bought from their website. That's all about these various reports from ProWritingAid. If you choose to purchase the premium license, you could also get a free copy of their ebook, which otherwise costs around $5 or $6 on Amazon. Once again, all these links are just a click away for you, conveniently provided in the description section below. Just to note that these are all affiliate links, which at no extra cost to you can give me a small kickback if you choose to use ProWritingAid. Finally, there is also something for software developers. The ProWritingAid offers web APIs that are available if you are looking to tinker and integrate ProWritingAid's features within your own apps and tools. Let's now see a comparison of Grammarly and ProWritingAid tools. Both these tools offer editing anywhere we write, offline or online. But only Grammarly offers their tool offline, even in the free version, whereas ProWritingAid's free version is available only for the web. If we need it within Word or use it as a desktop tool, we need to upgrade to their premium version. I thought that at least a minimum integration could be given for free users by ProWritingAid, but only if the web editor is available. If I'm not wrong, even the Chrome extension is free, so that's where we can write online without getting into the premium version. But only Grammarly offers their tool offline, even in the free version, whereas ProWritingAid's free version is available only for the web, the online editor, and the Chrome extension. If we need it within Word or use it as a desktop tool, be it on Windows or Mac, we need to upgrade to the premium version. I thought that at least a minimum integration could be given for free users by ProWritingAid, but only the web editor, the online editor, is available for free. If the limited 500 word check in the free version was also made available as an add-in within Word, then that would have clearly won over other similar tools like Grammarly, which offers a free Office add-in, a desktop standalone software, and also a browser extension. Overall, the threshold cap for the free version is kept on the number of words that we can edit at a time within ProWritingAid, only on the first 500 words at a time. Otherwise, almost all the checks and features that we saw earlier are available on the online tool for free. On the other hand, Grammarly doesn't limit on the words we check, but blocks out majority of the features on the free version, like these. Cost-wise, the ProWritingAid is certainly cheaper compared to Grammarly at its current pricing model, clearly setting it apart from its competition with no reason not to buy it. The downside with ProWritingAid, in my humble opinion, is that their paid version gives only 50 plagiarism checks per year, which is really less if you ask me, whereas no such limits exist with the paid version of Grammarly. Although not everyone would want to check on plagiarism, it doesn't make sense to limit its check, is what I feel. At least for the paid users, this check must be made unlimited. Next, let's talk about some content privacy. Grammarly collects the user content, as you can clearly see from their terms of use, the privacy policy here. Whereas ProWritingAid doesn't collect any of our work as mentioned on their FAQ section as seen on the screen. Finally, the contextual spelling errors that are not exactly errors but correct words misspelled in the sentence, which of course these mistakes are beyond any tool's scope to catch and thus only a human editing can solve. For example, on this sentence if you see, it says I place my cane firmly on the ground. If I change this to can, the sentence still holds good without the tool catching the contextual error, which of course only a human editing can solve. That's all about the ProWritingAid software. If you're interested in learning more about this, then you can even have some super helpful blog articles categorized into various sections from the footer of their website here, and in addition to some excellent resources for writers and authors, which are also available on the footer section here. The Word Explorer tool that we saw earlier on the menu bar within the tool is also available here under the footer section under resources, which is available for free online. It doesn't matter what type of user you are, be it a student, blogger, author, ProWritingAid will have you covered by helping you improve your writing and getting your ideas across more clearly. I hope you like this video. If so, please hit on the like button, subscribe for more such tech videos, and I'll see you again in my next video. Until then, you take care. Thanks for watching.